Hey, it's me, GV, and, hear me out. I know what you're thinking. So many series. Oh my god, here we go, another one. Listen to me. Also, I'm recording this really late. Holy crap. I recently got the platinum for this game, which, by the way, don't look at this if you don't want to be spoiled, but check that out. The platinum, every trophy, 37 out of 37, Slayer of Trophies, last night at 1:48 in the morning. All trophies obtained, ultra rare, 4.1% of players have earned this trophy, including me. And basically, in an effort to do that, I had to learn every single thing about this game. And I don't want that to go to waste. Demon's Souls brought me a lot of joy, brought me a lot of salt and anger as well, because that's the type of game that it is, and it's outdated in certain ways that they continued to, they decided to continue here. Point is, look, I don't want to have a big old intro. Look, here's the point. This is going to be a short series because this game is not that long once you know what you're doing. And Soul stuff has worked on my channel in the past, and I kind of just want to use all my knowledge for this game to provide a Let's Play because otherwise it's just going to go to waste. And I still want to play more of this game even though I've done everything in it. So that's really the point. For those that are mad that we're not going to be doing some other stuff as much because of the series, just keep in mind, again, this game is relatively short. This is the remake of the 2009 PlayStation 3 exclusive, meaning that this game is pretty short, even though it's a PS5 game. So yeah, bear with me. Just want to play Demon's Souls, and I feel like my gut is telling me this is going to be a good series. The other series will return, and I'll be, you know, recording all of them at once, pretty much. So, you know, we'll get a bit of this, a bit of that here and there. But either way, I hope you enjoy. Yeah, this is Demon's Souls. Like I said, got every trophy, have done everything in this game, and I want to use my knowledge to make a fun old little Let's Play. Let's do it. New game! Are you sure you want to continue offline? The following features will be disabled. Messages, bloodstains, eye stones, including but not limited to invasion, summoning help, and passwords. Here's the thing. I set it to offline because that's kind of what you have to do the character tendencies and world tendencies, and I'll explain that later on. Point is, I usually like playing online, but however, there are not scripted invasions in this game. So the only reason to play online is for PvP, which currently I have zero interest in for a Let's Play. I feel like it just kind of takes away from the Let's Play, in all honesty, for a Souls game. We're going to go offline. Choose a body type preference. We're going to go... I could do female, actually, because I actually already have a really cool preset female-looking character. But I think, actually, we'll go male. This game decides to do it in body type A or B, which is interesting nomenclature. Maybe that's how the first original game was. So we're going to go body type B. Then, God, I love the graphics, man. I don't know how well this is going to translate to YouTube, but, dude, when I first saw this character creator, when I first played this game on stream... my mind was blown. Like, everything looks so freaking good. I really hope YouTube preserves that. Okay, so player name, I typically like just going something that is an anagram of Vana. So that's Vaughn or Avan. I think I've had Avan or Vaughn before, so I think I'm going to go for this one. I'm going to do Avan. I typically always make my Souls characters either Avan or Vaughn or... I guess I could do, like, not... Oh, wait a second. What about... Nav. I've never done that one before. Perfect. Okay, then. We're going to do a saved creation, and I'm just going to save y'all the time. See, we've got this dude here. That was my first character. Kind of got in trouble with him because New Game Plus is so difficult, and I didn't do my original playthrough, you know, that well because it was new. And so then I kind of got mega boned in New Game Plus. Then... Her, we tried to beat the tutorial thing. You'll see what I mean in a second. So that was the female character I was talking about. And then this guy is my favorite character creator, character creation. So we're just going to go for him. This slot already has a character creation saved into it. What'd you like to do? I would like to retrieve it. Thank you. Okay, that should be, yeah. So yeah, I really like that feature. Put this in other games with character creators so that you can just save a cool... character, then, you know, continue it. As for class, what should we do this time around? Like I said, I kind of know this game in and out now. I think faith? Yeah, man, because that's kind of the one thing that I haven't done. I've done sorcery. I've done strength. I haven't done dex, and that's mainly because dex is very weird in this game. Faith could be interesting. That's kind of the one thing I have not done. Maybe faith, strength. Yeah, super duper paladin, huh? Which means, if we take a look at the attributes over there on the right, so level 6. I typically like going royalty because they start with 1. Plus, they're pretty overpowered, which I didn't realize. I thought this was the depraved. In the other Souls games, depraved usually starts with nothing, and I kind of like that as an added challenge. But yeah, this one starts at level 1, so I feel like you get the most stats, right? I mean, that's pretty much how it would be. But what starts with the most faith, I wonder? Here's Temple Knight with 13 faith, and where's the strength? 14 strength, that's not bad. Then we got no faith on this guy, the thief. Yeah, makes sense. Then we have the barbarian, also bad magic stats because he's a big bonky boy. Then we've got the wanderer, not too great there. Then we've got the magician who has a lot of magic but not a lot of faith. Then we have the priest who does have faith, and we have the same set that one guy has, as you'll see. The hunter, no. The knight, no. The soldier, no. I think we go royalty. I just feel like you get the most stats also being level 1. But I have started as this guy, like, every time. Although this starts with the halberd or whatever, which is also really good. And starts with a miracle. And starts with a talisman. You know, we're going to have to go Temple Knight, aren't we? Yeah. Yeah. It's going to be Temple Knight. So, a special knight that protects the Temple of God. Heavily clad and equipped for crowd control, who draws upon a restorative miracle. There we go. Yeah, let's do that. Boop. Okay, Nav. The Temple Knight with the starting gift of, so, as far as this stuff goes, I think Providential Ring is your best bet. All this other stuff you can get throughout the game, Providential Ring will give you some bonuses right off the bat. So we're going to go that, which raises item discovery. Foundation is good, appearance is good, and that is that. We could give him a different hairstyle, though. It would be nice to kind of make him a little bit different. See, I'm really proud of this character, dude. He looks really cool. Yeah, we could give him some cooler hair. Well, not cooler, but just, like, different, maybe. There was a couple of other styles that I did, like that one I liked. Maybe a super long-haired one, though. That's kind of, like, the first one. And then this is all female hair. Oh, the top knot. Ooh. We could do, not a top, you know, like a ponytail, I guess. Oh, that's kind of neat. Yeah, maybe. Can we make the ponytail work? Let's see. Which one looks more masculine? I'm trying to go for a masculine look here. That one. Do we go for the ponytail? I can't do it, I don't think. I don't think I can swing it. That's kind of like the Aragorn. Aragorn? Oh my god, I'm like the biggest Lord of the Rings fan. I'm forgetting at the moment, which means I'm not the biggest Lord of the Rings fan. I think we go for this. Yeah, he has the looks. He has just beautiful hair. Let's do it. That's the one. Okay. And I think we're good. Finalize.
King Alant the 12th, by channeling the power of souls, brought unprecedented prosperity to his northern kingdom of Boletaria. That is, until the colorless deep fog swept across the land. Boletaria was cut off from the outside world, and those who dared penetrate the deep fog never returned. But Valifax of the Royal Twin Fangs broke free from the fog and told the world of Boletaria's plight. That the old King Alant had roused the Old One, the great beast below the Nexus, from its eternal slumber. And that a colorless fog had swept in, unleashing terrible demons. The demons hunt down men and claim their souls. Those who lose their souls lose also their minds. The mad attack the sane, and chaos reigns. Valifax also spoke of the enticing power of the demon souls. Each time a demon claims a human soul, the demon's own soul is invigorated by the life force. And the power of a mature demon soul is beyond human imagination. Legend spread quickly. Mighty warriors lured by the possibilities braved the fissure to breach the accursed land. But none have returned. Bjor of the Twin Fangs. Yurt the Silent Chief. Saint Urbane. Skurva the Wanderer. The sixth Saint Astraea with her knight Garl Vinland. And Sage Frake the Visionary. The colorless deep fog slowly creeps beyond Boletaria's borders. Humankind faces a slow and steady extinction. The deep fog will eventually swallow all lands near and far. But Boletaria has one final hope. A lone warrior who has braved the baneful fog. Oh, has the land found its savior? Or have the demons found a new slave?
That's up for me to... Up to meet... God, I love fumbling just like cool things to say. Would you like to play the Journey to the Nexus? Boy, would I! So this is an optional sort of tutorial thing, but honestly, it has a really, really cool thing if we can do it. And you know me, go big or go home. Let's do it. Now, what's interesting is you can only play this Journey to the Nexus on a brand spanking new character. If you go to New Game Plus, it does not let you. So you have to do this successfully your first try.
Brave soul who fears not death.
Or you must start a new character.
I shall guide you to the fissure. So that you may lull the old one back to slumber.
Dude, this game is so cool. Outpost Passage. This game is so damn cool, man. God, they got the graphic. This is the best looking game I've ever seen, bar none. Like, genuinely. I cannot express how much when I first started playing this, my mind was just blown. Okay, so play style that I have is immediately get rid of the shield. Take that off and put that Talisman of God there in the left hand. And then we need, oh my god, our equip burden. See that in the top right? We need that to be like under 40%. So bye-bye. And then bye-bye. And then bye-bye. Yeah, we could probably put one thing on, but we're going to have to... Oh, look at that. God, not even... That's going to do it. Okay, how about the helmet? Okay, then maybe the pants? Oh, not enough either. Okay, how about the helmet and the glove? Wow, really? Okay, what about the gloves and the pants? Oh my god, this set of armor is so... it weighs so much. Yeah, we're literally going to have... Okay, how much armor is this? 14 armor, 9 magic defense, 12 fire defense. Versus... 22. Wait, can we do... Okay, probably the legs are the best. Yeah. All right. That's all we're going to... Yeah, we need a decent roll, because that's my play style. We start with the Providential Ring, since we have that as our starting gift, which raises item discovery, so enemies are more likely to drop items. And then as far as items, we just have Crescent Moon Grass. This game does not have Estus Flasks. This game uses healing grasses, which is interesting. So yeah, dude. Oh god. See, I'm just already like, I'm so excited to play this, which is why I must record it, you know? And I know that I should just finish a thing, but I'm sorry, man. I just have to. It's in my core being, you know? It's telling me you must, GV, you must play. You must play a Souls game. It's my favorite series of all time, for those that don't know. A lot of people think it's Elder Scrolls. Nope. It is this. Wait, that guy's online. What the heck? Wait a second. Why? Huh? Why did I just see an apparition? That was kind of weird. All right, so this is a tutorial. This, you don't have to play. You can skip it. And I'm not entirely sure. By the way, I'm not used to using a halberd. I'm not entirely sure if it was in the original game. I never played Demon's Souls for the PlayStation 3. I own it, actually, but I've never played it. So yeah, I know that this game... I have seen speedruns of Demon's Souls recently, though, after I beat this game on stream, which go follow my stream if you want to see more Souls content, because, hoo boy, do we do a lot of stuff over there. But anyways, let's see. Link is in the description. okay, let's hop over here. Yeah, that's a weird thing with Demon Souls, is that you can, like, hop over certain places. In fact, there's a massive secret in this game that you have to hop over certain things to get. Okay, what are you going to do, honestly, boy? You ain't gonna do a gosh darn thing. Whoa, 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 sir? I ask that you hold off on that. Okay, I thought we would get the double hit there, but that's okay. Boppity, boppity, boo. See you later. How are you? Not doing so well. All right, so and also, yeah, this intro. Oh, boy. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, so far, this is a hitless playthrough. We have not been hit. Oh, boy. See, the reason I love playing Souls so much is just because, obviously, the gameplay is so fun. You get right into it. You don't have to take a break every 3 seconds for lore and cutscenes and stuff. But also just because, like, I know it. Something. What the heck was that? I know mostly about this series more than any other series, like even more than Elder Scrolls, I would say. And you know, I'm not saying that I know a lot. I'm just saying that, you know, I played it a lot. Elder Scrolls and other stuff. Anyways, the Souls series in general, we're going to touch that Archstone, is just the one that I always just seem to, like, pour through all the information. Not the lore, but, like, you know, how to platinum, how to get every trophy, how, you know, what weapons are good, what weapons are bad, what every item does, stuff like that. I am interested in the lore, too. No, no, no. No, no, no. You're a bad man. We're going to give you a backstab. What do you think about that? I've noticed that I'm just most happy making YouTube videos when I have things to explain. You know? It makes me feel really good. And that is really ultimately why I'm recording this, because I had to learn about all of the crazy crap in this game to be able to 100% it, you know? Get all the trophies, get all the stuff, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And I want to pass that knowledge on to you. So I got to capture this lightning in a bottle. You know what I mean? Okay, we got our first blue-eyed knight. Oh, almost. Yeah, not used to not having stamina at all. Which brings me to my first point. Top left of the screen. Hold on. We got a health bar, which is red, obviously. No, 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 no. We have a blue bar, which is our magic, which we probably just have enough to be able to capture, cast this miracle. Which, by the way, what is this miracle? Let us see. This miracle is heal. Cast with a talisman. Has been learned. Currently attuned. It's elementary miracle. Restores the caster's HP. A succinct display of God's power. A great friend to warrior clerics who have departed on long journeys of solitude. Beautiful. We also have a blue bar, which is magic, which we need to cast that miracle there. And then we have a green bar, which is stamina, which determines how much we can sprint and also our attacks. Stamina is hugely important. Half moon grass is better than the grass that we have in the bottom there. Oh boy, there's just so many things to explain. I just might have to turn. Okay, ow. First of all. Second of all. I just might have to turn into like a Elder Scrolls / Souls channel. I seriously just have so much fun with these games, man. I don't know what it is. Obviously, they're hard and challenging, and I can be salty at times and stuff like that, sure. But like, wait, is there an item up there? Oh yeah, we can get that one. I forgot about that. You know, I don't know, man. I have so much fun with these. And again, it's mainly due to just being able to explain every little facet of the game, all the intricate little NPCs. And their quest lines, like anybody that knows Demon Souls, you know, the Mephistopheles quest line. Like, I did that last night to get the platinum. And, you know, a lot of people just, you know, they play this game, they like this game, but they don't even know what that is, you know what I mean? So, like, just to be able to explain all that feels good. Feels good, man. Not to be a know-it-all. It's not an effort to show, like, I'm the smartest man to ever live, especially when it comes to Souls. No, it's just more like, you know, people have oftentimes expressed that they really appreciate my Dark Souls remastered 100% series because they just learned a lot about the game and stuff, and that makes me so very happy. I know for a fact I am not the most, you know, knowledgeable when it comes to this game, but yeah. Okay, now, here we go. This is the boss right here. I shouldn't spoil things like that, but I'm telling you because this is going to be scary. We only have one chance at this to kill this guy. If we fail, we go right to the, you know, the actual game. But if we are successful, we get a really cool thing. And boy, do I want to be successful. I really wish there was a way to, like, save. I mean, there is. There is a way to save. But honestly, nah. So basically, we just have to get in there. Do I have any other items, by the way? Unknown warrior soul? No. And I can't equip that chest, right? Just weighs too much, right? Yeah, 41. See, when we have 41%, we go like this. Wait, what? What? Wait. I thought if it was above 40... Wait, hold the phone. Okay, what about 60? Yeah, there we go. Now we got the big fat roll. Okay. Huh. So wait, how much does this weigh? 8.1. That weighs 8.1. This weighs 5.4. Can we do these? It must be 50. It must be 50. That must be what it is. Yeah. 50 or higher, you get the big fat roll. All right. Make sure we have the good roll. We don't have the fast roll, but we have a good roll. All right. This is going to be tough. We basically can't get hit once pretty much. It's, yeah, don't psych myself out. Let's just go for it. It's the Vanguard Demon! God, it looks amazing. Okay. Ooh! Okay, all right. Now we stay behind him. Why are you kicking, you fool? Already with the kicks. That was quick. Whoa. All right, I'm already freaking out a little bit. Okay, he's got to do the big jump. Just stay behind him and don't freak out. That's all we got to do. He's got to do the jump, though. He is not doing the jump. Do the jump. There you go. Now heal. Yummy. All right. This guy takes forever to kill. Fair word of warning. I'm gonna switch to the other grass. He's got very slow, deliberate attacks, so it's not like it's crazy challenging or anything. Oh boy. I'm gonna stop talking. We're doing pretty well. I really want to show the special thing. Did that really miss? How? Oh no. Okay, that was scary. Okay, can you get away from the wall, dude, please? I cannot. I think we have it. Bah! Hell yeah, dude. Okay. Whew! That's scary, man. It's a very easy guy, but, like, it's the sort of thing where you get one shot, and your brain freaks out. At least my brain does. You know, I'm sure there's people that are like, oh, GV, dude, that guy's so easy. I don't freak out. Me, it's like, dude, I feel like I'm gonna get whacked, you know? But we did it. Okay, cool. Now we can see the really cool thing. Are you ready to see the really cool thing? Let's go see the really cool thing. Let's do it. We're going to touch the archstone, which basically is kind of like a bonfire. Archstones are one way, though. They're not checkpoints. That was the first rude awakening. Like, wait, what? What do you mean there's no bonfires in a Souls game? We get the gray demon soul in the top right there as well. And then we touch it. Where are we going? Let's see. Oh, I just realized that this is going to be perfect for my thumbnail, too. Unknown Egress. Yeah, shout out to the people that have played this game and are about to go, wait, what the heck? Yep. So I don't want to say anything about this. I just want you to see what happens. But we're also going to grab all of the items since we deserve it. I know there are some, like, I remember last time I was here, I had to check behind some pillars. What up, dude, by the way? Hi, nice to see ya. Hello. Goodbye. I'll be right with you, sir. Just give me one second. Full moon grass is a better version of the grasses that we have. There's a sneaky item here. More full moon grass. Hell yeah. I'll take that. Hardstone shard is an upgrade material. Sharpstone shard is an upgrade material. Renowned warrior soul is a usable soul. Same thing. And... wait, I thought you got something better than that. Yeah, what's up, dude? That is a scripted death. That has to happen. Basically, the game's way of saying, okay, so you beat the Vanguard Demon. Time to play the game regardless.
Soul of the lost withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended.
So the what now?
Soul of the lost withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended.
So the what now?
so the world might be mended.
Ah, gotcha.
This is the Nexus. It holds together the northern land of Boletaria. Thou canst not quit the Nexus, but the five archstones will guide thee to the outer lands.
You have died, and the Nexus has imprisoned your soul. You cannot escape the Nexus. Oh, yes, I can. However, by capturing demon souls, you can reclaim your corporeal body. We'll see about that. Hi.
Well, you slipped through the fissure too, did you? You came for demon souls. Or to save this land and be remembered as a hero. Hunting for demons? Try one of the archstones. Now go. That is why you came, is it not? To this accursed Boletaria.
Indeed.
You came for demon souls. Or to save this land and be remembered as a hero. But it's all the same. You're just another prisoner of the Nexus. We're welcome here. As long as we keep slashing up demons. You came for demon souls.
We're well.
Say something new, my blue friend.
You came for...
Okay, goodbye. And who are you, my good sir?
I'm Stockpile Thomas. When the Scourge came, I didn't know what hit me. When I came to, I found myself here in this Nexus. My wife and daughter fell victim to the demons. But I would be worthless in battle. At the very least, I hope to lend my assistance to you brave slayers of demons. I would be happy to lighten your load and look after any excess baggage.
Yeah, that'll do it.
When the Scourge came, I abandoned my wife and daughter and fled like a coward. When I came to, I was in this Nexus. I haven't dared venture outside these walls since. I wish I could do more. But I am ignorant of the world beyond these walls. My candle maiden cared for me during my first days here. She says very little, but has a kind heart. She's just the age my young daughter would have been. Poor, poor girl. Trapped here with her eyes occluded by wax. If only something could be done to help her. If only something could be done to help.
So Stockpile Thomas here organizes our storage. There's actually a carry weight system in this game, which is awful. I don't like it, but it's true to the original. So we can store our upgrade materials because those are persistent regardless. We can store the shield because we ain't blocking in any Souls playthrough ever on this channel. We can also store these helmets because they're going to weigh way too much. This game in particular is very rude with its equipment burden. It's very hard to weigh, to wear anything.
Your goods are safe and sound with me.
And not have a decent roll. It's very difficult indeed. Goodbye, Stockpile Thomas.
Best of luck to you.
And also to you, my good friend, who abandoned your wife and child like a coward, which honestly is messed up. Hi.
You new here? Are you here for my services?
Yeah. Don't mind my axe being right next to your head, by the way.
I'm just an ordinary blacksmith.
Halberd, I mean.
It's simple. Just bring me all the souls you can. In trade, I'll give you weapons. Or forge the ones you already have. With your souls, I can eke out a living, and with my weapons, you can go on living. Not a bad deal, eh?
Not a bad deal at all, my good friend.
If you haven't heard, there's another blacksmith at the entrance to Stonefang Mine. He's an eccentric old man, He knows his trade well. He's the only sane one left in a town of soul-starved men. If you do meet him... No, forget it. That stubborn old ne'er-do-well will just chase you off.
Will he now?
There aren't enough smithing tools in this temple to handle all the work. Only certain ores can be used to forge weapons. But you'll just have to make do and be thankful that I can do anything for you at all in this forsaken place. And be thankful.
Okay. So, this guy, Baldwin, can repair equipment, upgrade weapons, and we can buy certain things from him. In fact... Yeah, we'll stick with the halberd. I am going to get rid of it at some point because I do find the halberd's a little too overpowered, and I like a decent level of challenge. But thank you, my good man.
So interesting. I can tell you're not going to last long here.
You're very rude. I am, in fact, going to last long here. You will see. Also, there is a girl over here. Hello, girl.
Oh, my. How has this happened? Has God abandoned us for Kingaland, failing to show proper respect?
Oh, Mbasa.
Oh, Mbasa.
Oh, Mbasa.
Oh, Mbasa.
I love how she says that. Oh, Mbasa. Okay, so we can talk a little bit more about these people once we get in. I do want to talk to them because I do find their dialogue interesting. Plus, that's the only way to get any lore about what's going on. And there's going to be people that watch this series that are going to say, hey, GV, I'd like to hear that dialogue. In Dark Souls, it's short and sweet. So just bear with me as I go through. There's not too much. There's not too many NPCs and there's not too many, you know, lines of dialogue to go through. I think there's one more. Oh, they're not even. Oh, wait, a gosh darn diddly old second. That guy's not there. Yeah, because like I said, all the other playthroughs I've done, I've started as royalty, which has magic. Is there not a dude here? What the heck? Huh. Maybe these guys aren't here just yet. You'll see what I mean momentarily. For now, there's only one thing that we can do. There are some items we can grab maybe. Are those items here yet? There's some stuff to do in the Nexus, but they really want you to just do this first. So let's go to the Archstone of the Covetous King. Yeah, that's the only... Okay, yeah, let's do that. Balatarian Palace, Archstone of the Covetous King, Gates of Balataria, a huge stone castle in the heart of the northern kingdom of Balataria. Hungry soldiers attack trespassers, their souls stolen by demons, while nearby terrible dragons have taken roost. So this game is very... weirdly set up. And Blue Point Studios, who also made the Shadow of the Colossus remake, which I played on Twitch, and also the Uncharted collection, which I played off camera, they did a wonderful job recreating it, but they did not stray from the path at all. This game is faithfully recreated from the PS3 version. Oh, you're so darn cool, you big old dragon, you. You just wait. We'll get you one day. The Balatarian Palace, the Gates of Balataria. Okay, once again, so many things to talk about and explain. Some of the stuff will be explained by the game, but also this is a Souls game, which means it ain't going to tell you a gosh darn thing. In the top left, you can see that our health is being hindered currently, and this is because we have died, and the Nexus traps our soul, or our body, or whatever the effing heck. Okay, come here. You tried. Wow, they actually did get me there. That sucks. Let's see. So yeah, the grasses are used for healing. There is a door right there. The heck? There's a door right there. Now, you can go over there, but you need to do a certain thing. And I don't know when I should or should not explain that, because that is a... No. No. That is a thing that, is a doozy to explain, to say the least. Okay, let's see. Where are you guys hiding at? I know you're hiding behind all these things. Go ahead and make yourselves known, so I can give you one of them. Okay, now, yeah, we should... Ooh. This game is brutal. This game does not mess around. This is the type of game that, like, in Dark Souls 1 and 3, I don't feel bad using certain... Or I do feel bad using certain things because it's too easy. Okay, like that right there. Excuse me? Meaning... No! Oh my god. Okay. Gosh, the reach on this is, like, very deceptive. You think it would be just an inch longer... And no, I'm not going to make a joke about length. You can do that in your own head. It's too easy. Listen, I'm not even going to go there. Sir? That guy has a flaming sword. He's upgraded. Also, he drops pine resin, which, fun fact, in the original game was called turpentine. But they obviously made it resin to stick with what that item is called. In the Souls games, in the Dark games, you know, Dark Souls 1 and 3 and 2, I guess. But yeah, that used to be called turpentine. Okay, this is the way that we go. So yeah, this game is very weird compared to Dark Souls 1, Bloodborne, Dark Souls 3. In you go. There you go. They know their place. You don't want to fall in there, by the way. Those little things are like souls, which means you die. Hello. Very rude of you to be shooting me from up here. Not cool. We're going to use a grass because in this game, you want to be full health all the time. And that's what I was trying to say earlier, is that this game is no joke. This game in a lot of... Excuse me, sir. This game in a lot of ways is the hardest Souls game. Not the hardest. It's just that it's hard in a lot of ways that you wouldn't normally expect. In certain ways, it's easier, but it's also that sort of thing where, like, you know, it was like the first Souls game, so they just didn't give as much of, they didn't give as much of... They weren't as nice. It's like an NES game, right? Going back to the NES games. A lot of them are extremely difficult because it was just that old school sort of way of thinking. And I don't know, 2009, this game is just harder in certain ways. So anyways, my point being is that, like, I don't feel bad using certain things that I would feel bad about using in, like, Souls 1 or 3. Because at points, man, especially New Game Plus and New Game... mainly New Game Plus. I didn't find New Game Plus 2 as hard. But New Game Plus 1, oh my god, was it a doozy. Like, I barely got through that. And yeah, it was just... They are not messing around with New Game Plus in this game at all. And if you play it, you'll see what I mean. Okay, this guy right here is scary. Come here, scary man. Are you just not? Oh, okay. He's like, no, I'm gonna wait till you're, you know, you think you're safe and then go for it. Which is the nature of this game. It's kind of good that we're using the halberd also, because the halberd is easy. It's easy mode. But the good news is that we can get through more gameplay. Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay. 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 No, no, no. Oh, that's... Okay. That's some BS. That is some BS. Why did we not hit that guy? So we're going to back up and eat a grass. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Oh, you're just going to... Okay. You're going to make it easy on me, huh? You're going to drop down to my left. No. No. Now, we're doing pretty well thus far. The journey continues. This guy up here is going to be throwing some bombs at us. Luckily, we were able to pick that up and get out of there, though. We were able to skedaddle. Okay, out here, there's going to be a dude on our right. Sir, it's time to go. Sir? I told you, like, literally 40 minutes ago that it was closing time at this bar. You have to leave. I know it's a very oddly situated bar, but still. You must go. Am I funny yet? Are you guys laughing? Nice throw, dude. It's almost like you were tracking me through the wall, which makes no sense at all. Okay, now we're back up to where we needed to be. Now we're back up to where the bomb throwers were. Now, one thing I'll say is that I like this game a lot, and I like recording it a lot, but if there's a gosh darn boulder, I'm done. Like, I'm just flat out done. You know, and I don't think there will be one, but at the same time, I'm just telling you guys now that if a boulder... Okay, so I'm done. That's my really funny joke. What did you guys think? Now, that opens up this here, which gives us the bastard sword. But unfortunately, I'm not a bastard in this game. We're not role-playing as a bastard. Thus, we cannot use it, I'm afraid. Okay, so yeah, we'll try to get some miracles going. That'll be fun for this playthrough, because that is one thing that I have not done. I did buy all of the miracles except for two. And you might be saying, how did you get the platinum? Basically, to save myself a playthrough, I just realized... Ah, crap. I just realized that, okay, you need to go. Shoot it. No, you don't. Because of the way that I'm playing... Bye-bye. Oh, God. There are people that are watching this right now that might know what's up there and to the left. And, it's awful. It's genuinely awful. And we have nothing that's gonna help us out. In fact, I think I literally need to not do it. Until later. I mean, at least until opening the shortcut for sure. I constantly get myself trapped where I get obsessed on that, what's behind that quarter. And it's a bad, bad thing because you'll see why eventually when we kill him. I'm making a promise now that we will in fact kill him. but not at this very moment, because he is going to destroy me entirely. Okay, now there's an item down there, but before we go down and grab it, we want to do a thing. Oh, man. Like, see, I'm really knowledgeable about this, man. I'm only saying that because I'm surprising myself. I'm like, yeah, dude, I know all the little roots. I played this game quite a lot. I, like, did one entire playthrough on Twitch when this game first came out, which, once again, follow my Twitch, because everyone's like, GB, you need to play Demon's Souls. I'm like, yep, already did. On Twitch. Got too many things going on YouTube, which is why we'll never play Demon's Souls on my YouTube channel. Never, ever, ever. Especially not at this point in time, at this exact moment. No, you don't. But anyways, I did one on Twitch, and then I started a brand new character. We're gonna do that. Check that out. We're gonna do this. Check that out. Started a brand new character, and then I did another playthrough, and then I did a new game plus playthrough, and then I did about half of a... No, I pretty much did the whole playthrough, except for like one or two bosses of a new game plus two playthrough. So I played this quite a freaking bit. Nice one, dude. Okay, gotta be careful. Nice one, dude. What happened down there? He like blew everybody up or something. That was very fortunate. Try me. Try me. Try me. Or don't. All right. No. Oh my god. This stupid game. See that? Okay, we're gonna use our miracle now to get a free heal. We gotta make sure they're not following us. We're gonna press LB. I have never used that before. Okay, so yeah, you might be saying, how did you get the platinum trophy? You didn't get all the miracles. Like I said, you can upload a cloud save. Nice one. You can upload... Oh my god. Okay, they can actually explode these barrels from what I remember. So I'm worried about these two guys. There is no plunging attack, by the way, in this game. You might be saying, GD, you fool, use the plunging attack. And I say to you, let me show you what happens when I use the plunging attack, huh? I was pressing RB that entire time. Now, granted, that might not seem like enough of an animation time, but trust me. Oh, the cling ring. Oh, hell yeah. Okay, so that is the best ring in the game, pretty much. Less HP reduction when in soul form. So we're in soul form, which is why our HP up there is kind of capped off. That is a thing with this game that I absolutely detest and hate. Still to this day. Also, we cut those chains down, and look at what we get. Yee! Aged spice, old ragged boots, old ragged gloves, old ragged robes, of which we cannot wear, and a jade hair ornament. I'll show you what to do with that, too. Okay, so we just made a shortcut. So now if we die, we can come right to here and go back up, which is much easier, which is why I had to do this. Oh, man, I'm tempted to go for that one guy, but you guys got to understand, it's not about, like, oh, GV, you can do it, you know. It's more about, like, he literally has the most overpowered move in the entire game. And he is incredible. Like, they really want you to come back to that guy later on, and he's just gonna kill me, and we're gonna reset all of our progress, and it's not gonna be fun. So, in fact, I'm gonna make, you know, I have to say no. I have to. But let's just remember, yes, when we go all the way to the end of there and go left, right where that tower is, there, we still gotta do that, okay? Also, we gotta drop down here. Let's go grab this. Whee! Ow! This is an item everybody misses, and it's called the Wooden Bolt and the Light Crossbow. Isn't that neat? And then we can go in here, which is where that one dude was throwing firebombs at us when he decided to drop down and let me kill him, which was very nice. Also, I'm going to heal. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Now, notice we no longer can use that miracle. So how you use miracles in Dark Souls and in this game, because it's the same way, you have to have a talisman equipped, which, by the way, fun fact, I have never done a faith/miracle build ever. So this will be one of the only things I have not done in a Souls game, which is really neat. But, yeah, you need a miracle, and then you need to press Y to not two-hand, grab your little talisman, and then press LB to cast it. But, obviously, in the top left, it uses more than half of our magicka, or our magic. So, yeah, we can't use it again. But it does heal us, which is neat. It's kind of a free heal. Okay, so now we're going to go this way. And there is some interesting stuff we can do here. Now, most people, you see that man down there? To the bottom right, most people go to that guy from down there, and then he says, hey, can you help me find my egg? But we're gonna do the cool thing, and I'll show you the cool thing. So check out the cool thing after we kill this guy, though. Hold on. Get rid of that, because he's gonna try to explode it. Yep, like that. Nope. What? Oh my god. See, that's what I mean. Stuff in this game like that, that it's just like, dude, I don't even care about being cheap in this game, because it is just ludicrous. Some of the things in this game are just ludicrous. Okay, now you. I'm gonna roll. Try me. Nope. That's what you get for being a rude dude. An RD for short. All right, check this out. A lot of people don't know this either. Look, you can come over here and go like this. Check that out. Now listen, we get some cool dialogue now.
That was a bold leap. A surprise indeed. Well, now that you are here, pray thee, fend off these dreglings. That was a bold leap. A surprise indeed. Well, now...
Okay. So we will help him. Thief ring. That's another good ring. We're going to switch that out, actually. I'm going to remove these two, switch the cling ring here, because we pretty much always want the cling ring on. And then I'm going to equip the thief ring, which basically makes you harder to detect, so you can sneak up on enemies easier. And this guy... What the heck just happened? Oh, I took off and put on the cling ring, so that made us use a heal. Oh, that sucks. So this guy wants us to kill those dudes down there, which we can do with firebombs. However, we're going to save our firebombs. What's up, y'all? Okay. Oh, no, no. I got overcocky. Which is a problem with me, as I'm sure many know. Okay. And now he hops down. What's up, my good fellow?
My thanks for your brave rescue. I am Ostrava of Boletaria. Accept this as a token of my gratitude.
Give it to me, my friend. A brass telescope, which basically just acts as the binoculars from the other games. Hello.
Now I take my leave. There is something I must do.
I can do it with you, though.
No matter how far I venture, only the soul-starved remain. Is there a single sane person left in Boletaria?
Yes, it's your boy. What do we call this guy? Nav.
No matter how far.
Okay, well, good luck, my friend. Bye. Okay, so he has a quest line like everybody else, and I'll show you how to complete it. Isn't that neat? Unknown warrior soul. Whee! Okay, so I don't think he can. He can die because you can kill him like most other NPCs. In Souls games, but he's incredibly hard to kill, which is good for us because that lets us complete his quest line without worrying too much. But yeah, he is, you gotta watch out. And he will help us kill all these people now, which we need to heal for as well. There's the scimitar. Still haven't found a weapon that I want to switch to yet. I don't think we found a really good weapon. The scimitar has horrendous reach. It is laughably bad. What in the hell? I like how I got hit by that, which is just, again, one of the, this game. This game will do the most rude things to you. Half Moon Grass. Thanks, pal. Okay, so we're going to follow Ostrava of Boletaria in his quest. Oh, wow. He's actually taking some damage here. That is not good. We need to help him out. Yeah, don't just walk up to a quest. Here, this is how you... Oh, my God. This poor guy, man. He can't get anything happening. You see him just attack a wooden post there? Unknown hero soul. So all these souls we're getting in the top right, by the way, these unknown hero souls and things, those are basically, if you're bad at the game and if you die, you can pop those to still level up. Oh, God. Okay, there I go talking crap again, and I'm immediately going to eat crap because of it. All right, down here, Ostrava. Here, I'll show you. No. No. Stay down. No. I said no. I said... Uh-oh. No. Oh, my God. Oh, my bad, my bad, my bad. My bad. My bad. My bad.
You mustn't. We are.
I'm sorry. Here, let me make it up to you. Okay. Eat that. Yummy. Okay. Whew. Yeah, the halberd is overpowered in every Souls game ever, including this one. It's not as good in this one. It's definitely a little bit weaker. The range feels definitely shorter. But still, the halberd's moveset is just—it just has so much reach compared to other weapons that it's just like kind of silly, you know. God, I wonder, can we kill the first boss in this episode? We're going at a pretty brisk pace here. We still got a ways to go though. What do we got there? Unknown warrior soul. Okay, watch out, Ostrava. You're just kind of cruising, man. But there's like people all over. But look at this guy. He aggroed that guy, by the way. I don't think he... In this game, when people have their backs turned to you, you usually... and if you have the thief ring, you can usually sneak up on him and do a backstab, which is basically a giant critical damage thing. Okay, hello, gentlemen. If I could see my character, that'd be great. No, thank you. Bah! Okay, hold on. No, thank you. No, thank you. Let me do one of these. Thank you so much. We're gonna do one of those. Look at that. Beautifully efficient. Okay, let's do this. So, yeah, we're pretty much 100%ing this first area. This game's not that difficult to 100%, like, in terms of doing everything in a playthrough. It's hard to... You do need multiple playthroughs to platinum it, like, to truly get everything. But, is he over there? Yeah. But, yeah, this game's not that hard. Compared to other Souls games, this is honestly the easiest to get everything in. So, I don't know, man. I know we've got way too many series going on now, but I'm just saying, like, it wouldn't be too difficult to do everything. You do have to do all bosses in this game. Like, it's legit. Ow. Oh, my God. Stop. See, stuff like that is just kind of like, can you please, sir? Okay, I think we have to go up there to continue, but, wait, can we go that way? No. But we're going to go this way to patch up the last place that we haven't been to. Let's see. Nothing down there, right? That's where we came from, definitely. And I know there's some bad guys in here. Is there a dude behind? Where did you... The last time I played this game, that guy did that. And I don't even know where that guy comes from. Can I backstab you, sir? I'm the true halberd man. You are a falsity. You are a liar. You're a cheat. Oh yeah, there's a guy over here. Check this out. Look at this guy.
Good day to you. Care to look over my wares?
Care to look over my wares?
Mostly stolen, but who's telling me?
Not me, pal. Your secret's safe with me, buddy.
Brave knight or lowly fodder, the demons snatched their souls regardless of their station, plummeting them all into madness. And those who dare cling to their humanity were hunted down. It is the end of Great Boletaria as we know it. But hell, at least the demons don't send us
to
our deaths in battle. There's this skinny fellow, clad in the most lavish armor, who's always mumbling about some mission. He's another one who's managed to stay sane, like yourself. Probably some pampered little lordling by the looks of his attire. I'd give an arm just for the buttons off his shirt.
And he's talking about Estrava there, who we already met.
It is the end of Great Battle.
Okay, so everybody, like, tends to repeat their last line. So this is a dregling, and he's basically just a merchant that sells a bunch of stuff. We could go club, honestly. But that would be making the game harder, because the weapon we have now is overpowered. I think we'll stick with that just to keep the playthrough moving.
Go ahead. Take your time. I'm not going anywhere.
I know you're not. Actually, that's not even true, because this guy shows up in other places. He's a liar. Why are you... Don't even think about it, pal. Palerino. Let's see. You don't have nothing. All right, this is linking back up to where we left off, and you'll remember this area shortly. Remember this? We rolled into this firebomb-throwing guy, and we were like, no, you don't. See, we came from back over there. See that? So, yeah, I know this. Oh, God. I'm honestly really happy with my knowledge with this game. And that's why, again, I wanted to record this, because I'm just like, I have to use this knowledge, dude. You know? It's that sort of thing where, like, a blind playthrough. Excuse me. A blind playthrough is really fun because, you know, the person experiences a thing for the first time and somebody watches that and it's fun to see that. But also, a knowledgeable playthrough is also fun because you can just learn a lot, you know, about a game. And again, I'm not trying to sound egotistical or cocky or anything like that. I'm just saying that I had to learn a lot about this game to be able to get the platinum because there's some really weird stuff in it. And yeah, I just want to utilize that knowledge and energy to make a fun playthrough. Okay, this guy's a little scary now. No. Okay. Okay. Oh, oh God. Okay. Oh, yeah. All right. Oh, those guys are rough sometimes because, yeah, if you hit their shield. Okay, you need to go. But don't go all the way down. Thank you. We got some late moon grass there. Also, this has the thing where if you hold down on the D-pad, it'll go back to your default first usable item, which is a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful thing to have. Okay, so that is everything. Let's go through the fog gate, and we have a boss! Just kidding. No boss. Not yet, anyways. I'm going to try to beat the boss in this episode. I'm actually recording this super late at night, and so I wasn't even thinking of doing an hour-long episode, but it shall be done. Also, hit the right side of this right here. Or else, if you walk over here, all those boulders will kill you. But if you do that, look at that, you get a jump on it. Now, there's still people that typically live, and I'm looking at the end of the hall here, trying to find some people that are going to be particularly jerky. Soldier's Lotus heals... What does that heal? I feel like I've never even... Wait, what does that even do? Stops bleeding? Wait. Is that only for PvP? Because I swear to God, I don't think that's even been a thing. Maybe there's like a couple of enemies that use bleeding stuff. But yeah, I've never even had to use that item once. Okay, yeah, we're actually getting pretty close to the end of this entire level, so I think we'll just go for it. Whoa, God, these two guys, I forgot about this. Ooh, yeah, the halberd's overpowered, man. Really, really overpowered. Okay, so down there is a place that we do not want to go, so let's go. You'll see what I mean. This place is bad news bears. And there is a way... Again, I don't know how much I should explain... Because I don't want to over-explain, and there's just, it could be hard to explain all the intricacies. So, see that? Yeah. Yeah. There's a lot of items over there, and there's an easy way to get it. And we're not going to be able to do it now, so I think it's best for a Let's Play if I say, I'll show you that when the time comes, my little boy, my little lad, my little lady, or whoever you might be. Okay, so this part's interesting. Check this out now. Huh, wow, the ground sure looks blackened here. That's kind of weird. Bop, bop. Okay, so we're going to chill here for a second. No. Let's just walk around. Hey, how's it going, y'all? Hope you guys are having a good day. Okay. Oh, God. I always get one shot there. Okay, bye! All right, we gotta be careful here. Gotta be careful here. Gotta be careful here. Oh, my God. Are we gonna die? No! Holy shoot. Ooh. That was actually scary. Excuse me if you heard that cough. We're gonna say no to those items, by the way. We'll come back and get them. This guy's gonna be a big old jerk. It's killing me, by the way. Make a break right for this thing. This is a cool cutscene. That cutscene was so cool when I saw it the first time that I was like, there's no way that's in the first game, and it sure is. It's in the original. Also, a little item over here. Hello, unknown warrior soul. Goodbye. Yeah, see, there's items on that bridge, but we're going to have to say no siree, Bob. Thank you, but no. I'm going to go ahead and leave. Adios, muchacho. Okay, so yeah, it's another... Oh, God. You absolute jerk, you. It's another bridge in Dark Souls, which you know what that means. Okay. Jeez Louise. It's another bridge in Dark Souls, and you know what that means. It's going to be a dragon. You basically have to figure out how to run through it. I actually love that idea for a game. I like that that's a thing in Dark Souls in general. The series is that you have to, like, bypass crazy dragons and fire. On bridges, but the problem is that it's a little confusing for new players to figure out the timing and stuff. I don't think it's the most fair... Oh, God. No, no. Yeah, this game is no joke, man. I think I'm making it look easy at the moment. It's mainly due to the halberd, like, no joke. The halberd is just overpowered. And I didn't want to start with this. It's just because I wanted to go for the miracle guy, which it seemed like the temple dude was. Okay, we're going to have to be careful here. If we can make it down to the bottom, we're pretty much done, though. Okay. Whoop. Oh, God. These things always manage to find a way to hit you. See, look at that. Okay, that was just silly. All right, we're going to use the upgraded grass here. So these are, what do you even call? I don't even want to say what I think they're called because it's a bit of a spoiler. But they're little goops with a shield. Actually, it's not a spoiler because if you pick it, they can drop their shield. And if you pick it up, you'll see what it's called. I mean, regardless. But anyways, yeah, these guys are annoying. Incredibly high defense from the front. So you have to sort of flank them and hit their goop, you know? All right, let's see. We got more goop. I can hear it. Ow. God, that attack. It's just silly. I tells ya. It is. All right, what do we have here? Half moon grass. Yes, sir, Bob. Pull this. And now the entire map has been linked. Now the question is, do we have an Ed's sharpening stone? So actually what's crazy is we did every single thing in this entire first stage other than what's right behind that fog door. And we need to go where those dragons are protecting those items. And then we need to get the items on the dragon bridge itself. But those two things we need to wait for. Everything else we have done. So yeah, that's just, man, that's in less than an hour too with the tutorial. That's pretty clear and concise, dude. Now, question is, do we have an Ed's sharpening stone item in our inventory? The answer is no. Crap. Okay. Well, we should be able to just do this. This boss fight can go one of two ways. By the way, fun fact that you could do. Shout out to Oni Plays. I love that channel so much, and I didn't even realize this. You can sort of walk up this thing. Look at that. Yee. Oh, yeah. The other thing is that that door right there was locked, and we have to wait on that, too. And then you can go to that left side. That is another thing that I forgot to mention. All right. Well, here we go. Here goes nothing. Yeah, we should be able to do it. Actually, I can show you guys a really cool speedrun tactic. Check this out. So these are fire bombs, right? I'm probably going to fail this, but I'm going to give it a shot nevertheless. So what we want to do is grab this, go through the gate, look straight up, and then throw these fire bombs. Check this out. Okay. I don't think that did anything. But that is a speedrun tactic. I just don't know the correct area to do that in. We're going to heal behind this. It's the Phalanx boss. We're going to use a pine resin to imbue our halberd with fire. You might have remembered this thing. So satisfying, my god. You might remember this thing from Dark Souls 1. Oh, boy. You do not want to be there. Sorry if I don't talk much. Okay, a couple more hits here. Let's refill our stamina bar. Bop, bop, bop. And good night. God, I love this game. Ugh, what a great game. The visuals are just so good. So there is the first boss, the Phalanx. And this thing is actually in Dark Souls 1, and it's not a boss. But I didn't realize at the time, because I never played Demon Souls. And I was like, wait, what? Also notice we got our body back. So that's how this game is. This game is very weird. Everything's set up into levels, basically. There are 5 different worlds. And then each one has different levels. So we just completed 1-1. 1 being Voletarian Palace, or whatever the heck. And then 1-1. 1 being, you know, the other one being this first level, the gates or whatever. So you have to beat a boss. There are no optional bosses in this game. You always have to beat a boss to progress. And then you get your body back. But you actually want to die. I'll explain that in the next episode. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of weird crap with this game. It's insane. Anyways... That is a clear success. The game wants you to die before you do that, but we did it in one fell swoop because we are just that bad. So, in the next episode, we'll hit up this Archstone and see what we have in store. I enjoy recording Souls games so much, man. Like I said, it's just when you have that knowledge, it's just fun to talk about it. And obviously, this game, moment to moment, is just really fun. So, I know we're starting a lot of series. I'm not going to apologize because I just got to do what I have fun with, you know? And if it extends other series, I'm sorry, man. It's just, I started this job to have fun. And boy, do I have fun when I record Souls stuff. So nevertheless, I want to say a big thank you to everybody watching my stuff. This being the first episode, I have to plug myself a little bit. So yeah, if you'd like to super support me, the Patreon link is down there. If you want to throw a dollar my way a month, that'd be sweet, but no big deal. Also, liking the video is a free way to support the ever-loving heck. And also, comments are good for the YouTube algorithm. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you to the patrons that support what I do. And I will see you all in a... soon after I'd never use gestures in this. After I figure out how to wave, just give me a second. Is there no way? We'll just do this then. Goodbye. Hey, it's MeGV. Thanks so much for watching this video, ladies and gentlemen. If you want to watch more of me, I'm live on Twitch pretty much every day. Link in the description. If you want to support what I do, Patreon is the best way. Link is in the description. And either way, thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.